Hello guys, this is Tanik. Welcome to Learning Ladder of C Language. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about a call by value in the functions. I hope that everyone has a look of the previous tutorial video to know how to declare a parameterized functions and what are the types of functions are there in C language. What are the processes that we have to follow to use a function in the C language. Now, let me show you example with a call by value function in this C language. Here I am written a small program by using a method of call by value function in C language. Before the main function, I declare a function name with m parameter as int comma int. In the main function, I am initializing a value and b variable with 10 and 20 values respectively, and then I am calling a function name m by passing the value of a and b. So here I declare a definition of the function. Inside this definition of the function, I am using an integer ji and integer j. So this I going to hold the value of a that we are passing by the function call, and this j will hold the value of b that we are passing the function call. So this I and j are added and stored in the C variable, and we are trying to print a c variable. First, let me compile this program. Yes, we are getting 30 in the output screen. So this is one of the example for the call by value. Here we are calling a function with the value parameterized value by passing a value of 10 and 20. So this type of function call is known as call by value. Now let me show you what happened internally while we are calling a function by call by value method. Here I am calling a method as a and b. So this a and b values are initialized with I and j variables in the function definition. So this I and j values are added and stored in the b variable. So here I am using the same b variable in the function tool. So I am printing the function b. After the calling the main function, and once again I am printing a b in the main function. First, let me compile this program. We are getting 30 and 20 in the output screen. For our understanding purpose, I am declaring a new line. We are getting 30 and 20 in the output screen. Now, let me explain why this happened. So, the b variables are used two times in the program. One in the main function and other in the user-defined function called m. So we are getting different outputs. This is why, because this b not going to have any changes in the b variable that we are declaring in the main function, because these two b's have a different memory location. This is the main disadvantage in the function call by value method. This is why, because this effect of this main function call will be done within this function methods only. It's not going to affect any memory locations or any modulations in the main function variables. So by this method, if suppose we are calling any method, in a sense it's going to return some value, but it's not going to modulate or change any value that we are required in the program has to be changed. If suppose I use a call by reference method instead of the call by value, in the sense, then call by reference method will change the value permanently in the particular memory location. So if suppose I'm using method called by using call by reference, in the sense that the changes are made for the entire program, not only to the function definition. So this is the main difference between call by value and the call by reference. Now let me show you the various methods, how the various forms that are how these functions call by value going to be performed. Now let me see what happened if suppose I use the same variables for the both function call and the function definition. Here and now we are not in the position to use the same variable in the function definition itself, because this b variable is declared in the function itself. Suppose we are using the b variable once again here, then compiler will throw an error, the b is overrided. First let compile this program. We are not get so bad. Let's compile this program. We are not getting any error. We are getting output as 30 and 20 in output screen. So is not at all a problem by using a same variable for the function call and the function definition. We can use same variable. The compiler not going to throw an any exception. Now let's see what happens. Suppose I'm using a variable name directly in the declaration itself. First, let's compile this program. You're not getting an error, you're getting an output. So by this, we can have an idea that we can use a variable directly in the main function itself. Suppose we are using a main function, variables in the directly in the function declaration, in the sense the compiler not going to throw any error. Now let me see what happens if suppose I may use it and return type in the function call, in the sense. And declare a return type to the function call. Then first let's compile this program. We are getting an error that this function call, for the function call we should not use any return type in the function call. Now let's see what happened if suppose I'm used a parameter with a different data type and use a return type with a different data type. Here I'm used a parameter with an integer data type and use a return type as a character. First I have to. Let's compile this program. We are not getting any error. So by this we can have a conclusion that we can use any return type and any parameter. There is no relationship between this parameter and the return type. We can use any combinations of data types for the return type and the parameters. That's all about call by value in C language. In the next tutorial, let me discuss about the call by reference in the function call. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe to get alert for the next tutorial video.